The law that governs food safety in Uganda is the Food and Drug Act of 1964, which has not been amended to account for new technology, food safety issues and challenges. It is upon this reality that MPs have called for speedy enactment of the Food and Nutrition Bill to be able to promote the nutritional status of the people of Uganda through multi-sectoral and coordinated interventions.
And I'm very happy that we are talking about the Food and Nutrition Bill. I think that's really the preserve of Parliament. I'm happy there is a private member's bill in offing. And I think when I am preparing my brief report for the Right Honourable Deputy Speaker, for me that one will stand out loud. And I'll tell him that we really need to fast track the issue of the Food and Nutrition Bill.
Members of Parliament have decried poor planning that has contributed to endless food shortages in the country despite prolonged rainy seasons.
Sometimes we are not fed. We don't get the adequate feeding. And I'm sure when most of you traverse your constituencies, you're able to see a man who should be about 80 kilograms, but he's maybe 42 kilograms. Some of these people eat one meal in 2 days.
According to the Commission of Food and Food Security in the Ministry of Agriculture, Alex Bambona, some parts of the country are still experiencing food shortages despite rains, and these include Karamoja and some parts of the eastern Uganda, although the country is in the comfortable position to actually achieve food security.
As a nation, we are concerned when some groups of populations within our country have unacceptable levels of food security and malnutrition, despite our high endowments. We should be very, very ashamed of this. As we are aware, 2 years ago, the world has affirmed that ensuring food and food security is the most sustainable way for removing people from poverty and improve their livelihoods. That was the recent Food Systems Summit.
The country director of the Food and Security Organization of the United Nations, Antonio Querido, has urged stakeholders to use the Nutrition Week, which started off today, to advocate for food safety in the country.
To create more strong advocacy for the transformation of agri-food system here in Uganda, to accelerate what we would like to achieve by 2030.
Experts from food safety organizations urged Ugandans to avoid eating ground nuts and other related grounded foods by machines and instead pound ground nuts on their own so they can protect themselves from deadly non-communicable diseases that arise from taking ground nuts pounded by machines, which they say contaminate the product.
Like the metallic chips that come from the machines that grind the G-nuts, sometimes you find that those machines are rusted and those metallic chips flow in with the G-nuts, which cannot easily be detected by us, the immediate consumers.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.